and I don't mean maybe. You broke my heart from the start, now you know I'm bound. I gotta put you down. I love you truly the day you went away. I love you truly, and now my dear, it's all I need. Ain't I giving you all my love? Now ain't you my little thing now? Then either prove it or remove it, cause I'm going to town. I've got to put you down. But now, my dear, that's all passing. Can either prove it or remove it, cause I'm going to town. I got to put you down. I got to put you down. We got to put you down. I got to put you down. We got to put you down. Then either prove it or remove it, cause we're going to town. I gotta put you down!
No. don't you answer the phone?
Okay.
On your pins. I'll be right back. You was all right yourself tonight, and someday when I get me a real showing, you're gonna get a good part.
You've been mighty nice to me, Mr. Lem. You gave me my first real break in Harlem.
Yeah, Dom. I've helped a lot of men show business in my time. But somehow or another, they didn't let me do the one thing in life that I want to do most.
Well, someday you'll do that real show, Mr. Lem. You just keep punching.
Thanks, Dom.
Good night.
Hello, good night.
Listen, Master, you ain't seen nothing or heard nothing, see? Now, blow. Lem Anderson saw me turn the trip. Are you sure he saw who did it? He must have rubbed his 1 or 2 feet away.
You're a sap, you fool. Right in the stage door where everybody could see you.
You're just gunning for.
What were you doing backstage for? I know you're trying to see my gal down.
Oh, forget it, will you? What is that actor guy's for? You gotta bump him off, don't we?
Please don't let him do it, Rob.
Shut up, doll.
We gotta do something, Rob.
We won't wait any longer. Let's knock him off.
Don't get too ambitious, Ganaway. We'll do something about this, all right. But there'll be no more killing, and that's final.
Thanks, Ruff.
Now listen, Mugs, here's what we're gonna do. Spanish, you and Ganaway get to that actor guy and tell him I say...
Glad to see you, Mr. Lem. Why, what's wrong? You look like you've seen a ghost. The doctor's been here, and he says he's Sammy's work.
Thanks, Acme. You can go home now, honey. I'll take care of him.
Well, how's my little sweetheart tonight? How do you feel?
Wait a minute. I'll get you something for that cloth, honey.
Here we are. Here's just what you need. Now, you take one of these, and you're going to be all right.
How do you feel, honey?
What's wrong, Lem?
Well, wrong? What?
Well, there's nothing wrong, honey. What makes you think something's wrong?
I know. You're worried about me.
Oh, no, I'm not.
I reckon I won't be with you much longer, honey.
Oh, Emma, don't talk that way.
You're going to be all right, honey. You're going to be all right.
But it's you I'm worried about. Why, Lem, your hand's shaking like a leaf. What's the matter, dear?
Well, I wonder who that could be at this hour. You right back there?
Yes?
What can I do for you?
Not what you can do for us, it's what you can do for yourself.
You ain't seen nothing tonight. You ain't talking, and you're leaving town.
Leaving town? Who says
this? Is an album?
No, you make you dig a hole in the river. Well, what do you mean?
You heard me. Breathe.
Come on, let's slip in more action. We're not here to argue, we're here to tell you. Honor, but why should I leave
town? You're to say, don't start anything.
Yeah?
You'll be sicker than dead if you don't get out of town.
Oh.
I don't... Emma, what are you doing? You rats! You'll kill my wife! You'll never get me to leave home! I'll see you angry!
No, you don't want any more death in your family, do you?
You got a nephew in Harlem, you crazy about. You wouldn't want anything to happen to him, would you?
You wouldn't dare harm my nephew!
No, well, the same thing will happen to him if you don't get out of town.
Come on. Get out of town. I done told you. Get out.
Yeah.
Notorious gangster murdered. No trace of killer.
Solid.
Hey, you get out of town. What do you mean, get out of town?
Stop orders.
Get out of town.
Well,
you can't do this to me.
You never acted like this since you moved in here.
I'm sure it'll do you good. Go away.
Yeah.
That's right, Liv.
Sure.
Maybe a trip out of town right now would be good.
Yeah. Oh, my help. But where will you go?
Where will I go? Why, back down south where I came from, of course. Sure. Swanee River, here I come.
Mm-hmm. you for killing my wife.
Killing? How long did you give?
2 weeks.
2? Mr. Foley, did you got your gun with you?
Yeah.
Loan it to me a minute, will you please? Thank you, Mr. Foley. Thank you. Stop kicking that left leg. That shotgun. Thank you, Mr. Foley. Thank you very much. excuse me. Yeah, let me get these things on good, just, you know, I don't want to get away. They're on good.
I forgot to tell you, after 2 weeks, they're going to hang me.
What? Now, get out! Get me out of these things, Jeff! Get me out of here! Oh.
Hey, you! What do you mean going out on my stage like that?
What's the matter now?
Why, you're drunk again, that's what's the matter. And you spoil the whole performance, so you're through.
I get my laughs, don't I?
Oh, scratch it! Just because you was a big shot up north. Well, you can't come down here and ruin my show. And you're setting a bad example for the whole troop. Forget your things and breathe, brother.
What do you mean?
I mean, catch the man.
Well, don't I get a 2 week notice?
No.
Yeah,
no. You ain't got no contract, have you?
You know I ain't got no contract.
Well, you ain't working here no more, so get your things and get out of here.
Wait. Now, wait a minute, Jordan. Just a minute. Hey, listen. I ain't been right since I lost my wife. I had...
I'm nuts on your wife. It's you I'm talking about, isn't it?
Wait a minute. That's wrong. Now, don't talk about my wife like that.
I'm nuts on your wife. It's you the one that's missing.
I'm asking you...
Take your hands off of me, you dirty buzzard!
But it's crooked just the same.
You're telling me?
I phoned wrong. At the wrong time. Friday 13.
So what, Papa?
Well, that leaves me behind the eight row.
Oh, Joe Lewis was born Friday the 13th, and he made the grade.
And how? Think I tried to let this block and get away.
Yeah? But they tell me that fight racket is a tough one.
No more harder than starving.
I guess you're right, exactly.
Say, look here.
What?
Honey, I see. He's all packed up.
Don't make that weak so strong.
And don't you start putting on the wrist with that bone too big.
What do you mean?
Because it ain't gonna last you long.
Money don't make me. I make money. So, brother, I'm still queen for a day. Why, you no good clown. I told you I'd bring you down. So now you listen to what I've got.
Die.
And I'm sober as a judge, so I can't be talking to my head.
kid.
No.
I said Mr. King when he asked the kid.
And when did you become a son?
I said Mr. O'Neill, and I promised him that nothing did you.
So,
honey, how you figure I learned with you?
Well, I know that you remember when you were jiving and Jones for a
well, yeah, I
well that. What's called for the goose is catch up for the gander. You're going to roll on your pallet till early dawn. It's really going to drag you, old man, when you find out I'm definitely gone.
Now, listen, honey. I didn't miss my first wife. You want to die
again?
I didn't miss the investigator and that rascal. Burned up my chain. I didn't miss the WP. We are eyes on the statue.
Oh,
I said, if you ever think that I'm one of the missus.
Look, Rappin, dash me on that to the piano. Just go over there and ask him about that job, yeah?
All right. Sure is.
Hello there, Steve.
What are you going to say, little guy?
Hey, yeah. I hear that you done dined up for that show that's wine up and off.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't love John and Winter. See, we get through here at the theater tonight.
Well, sure. Go see the man.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, but wait a minute. If we're going to talk to the man about a job, I'm going to do the talking. Because he's going to come up here using all them highfalutin words, and we ain't going to never get no job.
Why, boy, I am really surprised at your vocabulary.
Now, you see that? That's a word that ain't never been in the dictionary.
I'm so sorry that my language is a bit too high for the common element. Perhaps I should drop a dominion law where he could grasp my meaning. Now, after those few remarks have subsided, I shall proceed further in the proceedings. You don't know what I'm talking about, but I'm going to say it again. Now, after those few remarks have subsided, I shall proceed further in to the pro...
Uh-huh. I'm glad it choked you.
Well, I said it the first time.
You think you said it right that time?
Right. Oh, go ahead.
Well, I said it this.
Oh, shut
up. Hey, big boy. Ain't you gonna buy nothing? Hey.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on and get up, Father.
Ain't that the Anderson?
Sure. What's he doing here?
What's the matter with him, Rocky?
I come in here and run out of dough.
Well, we know him. He was one of the biggest men in show business once.
So what? That ain't paying for my brawl.
How much do you owe you?
Oh, yes.
Give him 2 bits, Laura. I'll see what I can do for them. I'll pay you there. Come on, then. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up. And you high as a Georgia pine.
Don't you know who we are?
Hello, Steve.
Oh. What are you doing in this juke joint?
Just quit Jordan's show.
Yeah, we heard about it.
Yeah, Jordan put up an awful squawk. I guess you're through in the South.
I had this motive. Do you know what... Oh. But here.
Yes, you had a pretty bad shape.
Thanks, man.
Oh, that's all right. You were pretty swell to me and my first old lady when we were trooping in the South together.
I certainly wish you would stop bringing your first old lady into my life.
We quit that show that you was in with us, and we're now working our way back to New York.
You want to join us?
You want a man to play on Catone? You can play him, can't you?
I've been playing on Catone all of my life. I don't want to play on Catone. Shakespeare. That's what I'm going to play. Shakespeare.
Better stick to the thing you know best and leave the other fella racket alone.
Well, you know what a hard head makes.
Put some meat on there and it'll muffle it.
All right. Muffle it.
Oh. Look out for my feet, will you?
Oh, man, what's the matter with you?
No one bang, boss, now. This ain't right.
What ain't right?
Slipping out on Miss Mamie like this. We owe that woman 4 weeks rent, don't we? Yeah, but you can't keep blood out of a turnip.
But you can put old turnip in jail. Well, go ahead and move it. Watch out for my feet, too.
Oh, man, I've been moving all the time.
Well, Peter, listen, watch out for them feet. Get your feet off the
roof. Well, where are y'all thinking going with them food sacks?
We ain't going nowhere. We just coming in.
Yeah. You sure you're lying?
Yes, ma'am. I know.
Listen here.
Yeah.
I used to be a show woman myself. Mm-hmm. I knows what y'all forget. Now y'all go right back upstairs to your room and don't be late for dinner.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Get along.
Now, wait, you come on. Go quick. You ain't gonna step on my foot.
Go right on upstairs.
We'll be back for dinner. Don't worry about that.
All right. You'll pay me someday.
Instead of the ham what ham, this is the ham what ham.
Hello, Miss Mamie.
Oh, hello, Miss Daisy.
How do you feel, all right?
Fine. Did you get my message?
Oh, yes, I did.
Yes?
I managed to talk to those people.
Oh, yes? Well, they're right inside. Come right on.
Thank you.
Miss Mamie.
You're a
lucky girl. That's why you're so funny. Folks, this is Mr. Avery, Lem's nephew. I told him you had something to tell you.
Glad to know you. How are you, folks? Well, go right ahead. Don't mind me.
We know your Uncle Lem.
Oh, yes?
He's in a pretty bad fix down south.
He sure needs help.
Well, what's the trouble?
Well, we told him when we got to New York we were going to stop here with Miss Mamie.
And he said, be sure and see that you was all right.
Oh, that's nothing. He always did worry about me.
But he sure needs help something awful. We did what we could for him.
I know where you can find him. If you can get him back up here, maybe he'd get started again.
I got an idea, Ned. Brother Moe's church wants to do a high-class play.
That's right. Perhaps you'd let him put on Othello.
That would be nice. I'll go see Brother Moe tonight.
That's a great idea, Miss Mamie. And you could bring Uncle Lem back, too.
I sure would like to see him again.
I'll see you later.
That other actor guy?
Ain't nobody else.
What is he doing in Harlem?
Merchants and law, maybe. Well, well, Miss Bluford, I'm mighty glad to see you again.
Well, Mr. Angleton, how are you?
Well, I'm quite well for an old timer. Tell me, what's all the news here in Harlem?
Oh, nothing. Everything is quiet.
Everything quiet, eh? Well, that's true, all right.
Well, where have you been?
I've been south, Miss Bluford.
For your health?
Yes, I guess it was for my health.
I think I'll sap him.
Wait a minute. You tail him. I'll get rough.
Jam up.
But you know one thing? It's really a pleasure to get back here in Harlem again. I love it.
Well, it's a pleasure having you back.
I'm glad to be here. I'll take the stick.
I thank you.
Give my regards to your husband.
I'll do that.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
I think it's great that Uncle Lem's coming back into Othello. And I'm sure it'll be a great success.
And my church people agree that this production of Othello will make for better entertainment in the community.
And just think of it. It'll reach the man who never goes to church.
Exactly, Desdemona.
Won't Lem be happy acting in Othello and at the same time helping the cause?
All of my people are enthusiastic, and the spiritual uplift will be tremendous.
Gee, I wish they'd come. I'm so anxious to meet Ned's uncle.
Are you sure it's him they saw?
Dead sure. Dunaway's trailing him now.
Well, you get word of Gilson to show up my office as soon as he can.
Now listen, boss. You better watch Gilson. He never got over the fact that you snatched all Davis from him.
Don't you worry about Gilson. I'll take care of him. Here you are, son.
Now, come on, Gilson.
If Brother Anderson will faithfully work with us, this play will be to the everlasting credit of Harlem.
It'll be the dream of my life if he'll let me act with him.
Oh, you'll act with him, all right.
Hello, folks. Is Lim here yet?
No, he hasn't come yet.
I hope he heard us. I'm glad to go.
Hello.
Oh, where's that?
Oh, now, sit down, Bruno. Sit down. Y'all make yourself comfortable. Listen, you know, we're all going to have a great show when Lim comes.
Come on up, they're all waiting.
I wonder what's keeping me. Oh, here comes Lem now. Oh, hello, Lem. Lem, and if you ain't the same person, you haven't changed a bit.
Doggone, Miss Mamie, you look younger than ever.
You think so? Did you have a fine trip?
Oh, Miss Mamie, I had a wonderful trip. We laid over in Washington for about a half an hour, but I was very impatient because I was in a hurry to get here to some of your good biscuits.
I knew they'd draw you.
There.
There. This is my surprise. Yeah. My fiancée, Miss Desdemona Jones, is going to play opposite you.
Hello,
Uncle Lem. Desdemona? Mm-hmm. Why, that's the name of one of the leading Shakespearean characters.
That's right.
Desdemona. Oh, you remind me so much of my Emma when we were married.
Thank you, sir.
You've made a fine choice, my boy, and I'm sure you're both going to be very happy.
Thank you, sir.
Lem, I want to introduce you to Brother Bones.
Glad to know you, Brother Bones.
Glad to meet you, sir, but the name is Mold.
Oh, come, let's sit down and have something to eat. Oh, now, what's all the help you,
Lucky, huh? Must have a rabbit foot.
Hiya, boys.
Hi.
Now listen, you dudes. I told you no more killing. I'll pitch this in the paper again. And the time anybody even runs too fast in Harlem, the cops come to me.
Well, suppose that ham act is poor.
Well, you gotta figure out a way to get rid of him easy.
Oh, John? We could get the nephew out on our way. He lives.
Hint to him might do some good, huh?
Yeah, we can convince him that we don't want an uncle around here.
All right, but take it easy.
Okay, Chief. See you later.
What, fishing and everything?
Oh, sure, that's a good idea. Why not?
Well, what are you waiting on? There's a plenty of talent right here.
All right, let's get started then.
Let Miss Mamie start us off.
Huh?
Come on now. You think that's an old song? You know you've got a long time before.
so blue. I don't know what to do. Sometimes I said he'd die, and then began to cry. He went away and never even said goodbye. There's a change in the ocean, change in the deep blue sea, my baby. I'll tell the world there ain't no change in me. My love for that man will always be. Now I've got the Harlem blues. My man went away. I ain't got no time to lose. Yes, I must find him today. He makes me feel so blue. I'll do things I wouldn't do. I'll be like the Chinaman Bay calling hop. Gonna stand on the corner, gonna blow my top. Since my love has been refused, now I've got the Harlem blues.
Harlem, Harlem. Now she's got the Harlem blues. Yeah, she's got it. Since the man is gone away. That dirty man has done her wrong.
Boom, 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 boom.
He left her feeling blue.
Boom, 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 boom.
Doing things that she wouldn't do. She's going down to the river. She's a rope and a rock. Tied round her neck and up over the dock. Because her love has been refused. Now she's got the Harlem blues. Her brain is reeling. Now she's got the Harlem blues. Her crazy feeling. Now she's got the Harlem blues.
Ah, that was fine. That was great.
Thank you,
Brian.
That was great,
all right.
Well, I'm glad you liked it.
Ooh, we liked it.
I was a little out of practice, but the boys helped me out.
You don't make like four times I went out of practice. Let me tell you something.
Well, folks, I guess I must be going now. My deacons are anxious to hear of this meeting.
Well, good night for the Moans.
And you'll be ready to start your rehearsals immediately?
Immediately? Why, Brother Moans, I've been waiting for this opportunity longer than you have.
Well, good night, children.
Good night, Brother Moans. Thank you very much.
Brother Moans, you're here.
I'm happy about this myself, my child. Good night, children.
Good night.
Good night. Good night, Brother Moan.
Well, we must be off, too. I promised to get Desmond home early.
Well, good night, children.
Good night.
See you in the morning.
See you later.
Good night, Dad. Good night, Desmond. And,
Miss Mamie.
Yes?
Take care of Uncle Lem now.
Don't worry about that. I'm not going to let him out of my sight.
I know that.
Miss Mamie, you're a knockout.
Just like you always been.
Hello, Chick. What's this joker trying to do? You had a good time?
Yeah, maybe you need some help.
That'll be enough out of you.
That's it. Well, you saw more of a dame with a name like that.
Why, you... Uncle Lem! Miss Mamie! Somebody! Come and look what they've done!
You'll be all right, my boy.
I hope so.
And on that, you were pretty lucky. If this came down a half inch more, we'd have had trouble with your sight. I tell you what you do, Ned. Drop into my office and say a day or two. I want to check and see that that heel fits.
Okay.
I want to bid you people good night.
Good night, Dad.
Good night, Dad.
Thanks for
helping. Good night. Thank you for calling.
Good night.
something, Ned?
Okay, honey. Well, I wouldn't worry so much about it. Uncle Reverend said it wasn't serious.
No, it was dreadful. Why, he might have been killed.
And you're sure you don't know who did it, Ned?
No, I don't know.
Oh, they said something about making you remember, Uncle Lynn.
Hoodlum, they ain't got no respect for nobody. Come, gentlemen, I'll take you home.
Are you sure you'll be all right, dear?
Oh, he'll be all right, Josh.
Absolutely, don't worry.
All right, then I'll be around in the morning, yeah?
Okay, sweetie.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Take care of yourself, Ned.
Nice. Oh, you'll be all right.
Don't worry about me. I'll be all right.
Ned?
Yes, Ned.
There's something I've got to tell you.
Yes?
Do you remember that Slim Jewett killing some time ago?
Slim Jewett?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, yes, the gangster who was killed in front of the stage.
Well, Ned, I saw that murder.
You did?
Yeah.
But why didn't you notify the police?
Oh, that's just it. I couldn't.
What do you mean you couldn't, though?
Well, after the killing, I went home. Amoxie was terribly sick. Two men came to the house and told me if I didn't get out of town, you'd get the same as Slim Jewett.
Oh, this doesn't make sense.
Oh, the whole thing don't make sense.
What did they do to me?
Look what they did to you tonight, Ned.
You mean...
That's it. You see, Ned, I didn't want to spoil your career, so I thought I'd better go away again.
If I had only known.
I've made a mess of it now. I think I'd better go away again, Ned.
Oh, no, you don't. You'll not sacrifice yourself for me again.
But what else is there to do?
You're staying right here and concentrating on Othello. We'll handle it somehow.
Solid boy.
Hello, Gene.
Hi, Galloway.
What do you say, Spanish?
Okay, Chief.
Sit down, get yourself a drink. Straight ride.
Make it double.
Well, what's a jive now?
That actor's still hanging on.
He's been rehearsing for a week with the church folks of a half-rod family.
I had my way of putting in church in a bark.
You say church people?
Yeah, that joker's got all the churches in Harlem behind him.
There's only one way to be safe, Chief. Rub him out.
Five pounds. Bad enough to have the cops down on us. If we get these church people down on us, we'd all have to blow town.
What are we going
to
do about him, then?
Well, what do you say we get him in, church? What do you say we get him in wrong? Throw some women in this lab. Get him drunk. These churches saw on him, he's gone gobble.
He's a pretty wise old Oscar. He wouldn't fall for it.
Yeah, he's not smart enough to duck the woman I'm going to throw at him. There she is.
Hey, Chief. Yes, Ruff. Tell Dal Davis when I want to come over here to the table.
Okay, Ruff.
Tell him what Dal Davis is in this.
That's a chump. Dal's in my stable now. You get it?
This is fair, Ruff. You and me supposed to be pals.
She ought to know who she wants by now, and I'm the head man.
Stop, fella. What do you want, Ruff?
What do you have to drink, baby?
Scotch and soda.
Hey, waiter. Get Miss Davis a scotch and soda. Listen, babe, I got a little job for you.
Yeah, but it's Ruff's idea, not mine.
You see, I wouldn't expect you to have the idea.
Now, wait a minute. Doll, this is me, Matt Gilson, remember? I take you to your first show, gave you three squares a day.
So what?
Cut it out quick. Listen, babe, you remember that actor guy, Lem Anderson?
Yeah, whatever's become of him. He's okay.
He's putting on one of these here theatrical plays here in Harlem.
That's great. I wonder if he'd give me a job.
You're going to work for him, baby.
Work for him?
Yeah.
What's on your mind?
Get him excited about you. Get him drunk. Anything. We'll do the rest.
Why couldn't he do
it, Ralph?
He thinks I'm a good kid.
Look, if these church people get sore against him, he'll have to leave town, and that'll be for his own good.
I'll go and tell him to do
that. Sit down. You'll do it my way. Now, here's what happens. You invite him to your apartment. You get him drunk. Get me?
Why couldn't do it, Ruff? You're asking too much.
I saved his life once for you. Now, I'll do it again if you do as I say.
Well, folks, thanks to Brother Moans here, we've reached the stage of our first rehearsal. And as you all know, Othello was a Moor.
He was a what?
He was a Moor, a Moor.
What kind of man is that?
Well, you see, he was a general in the Venetian state.
Mr. Lamb.
Huh?
Is that in the United States?
He married Desdemona, Brabantio's daughter. And later on, his good friend Iago makes him believe that his wife Desdemona is unfaithful. And in Act 5, Scene 3, I think that's called the handkerchief scene, Othello in a jealous rage kills his wife.
Ain't that a shame?
But later on there, when he finds out that his wife is innocent, in a tremendous climax in the last act, Othello kills himself.
Then what?
And then Othello dies. That's the end of the play. Desdemona, just a moment, please. Now, in the handkerchief scene, Desdemona, you'll be stage right on a couch, asleep. I'll come in and I'll do my lines. I walk toward you.
Mr. Lamb!
What's the matter, honey?
We ain't never gonna get the show on.
Well, why not, act?
Because Sam Jenkins is upstairs in the dressing room with a big bag of peanuts.
Can you imagine that? Peanuts.
Oh, Acme, honey, what's wrong with peanuts?
Backstage, peanuts are bad luck.
Why, the hardest lick I ever hit my voice so late it was for bringing peanuts in the dressing room.
Peanuts.
Look out, Relief. You've got me in your power again.
Is Mr. Lem Anderson here?
Does he know you?
Just say it's Dal Davis.
I see.
Miss Anderson, someone's there.
Oh, all right, Dory. Relax, you all. I'll be back in a minute.
Oh, hello, Mr. Lem. Remember me?
Do I remember Dal Davis? Why, sure I do.
I'm afraid I'm not doing so good.
Why, you look like you're doing all right, honey.
Well, you never can tell. I suppose you wonder why I'm here, don't you, Mr. Lem? Well, I heard that you were doing a play,
And you did say, if you ever did one, that you would give me a part, remember?
Oh, sure I did, doll.
I guess we better be going, too.
I think so. Excuse us, folks. Good night.
Good night, Brother Moon. Good night. Good night, y'all. Say, come on, y'all. Let's get the rehearsal started.
My Lord. My Lord. What ho, my Lord. Hey, Lem, where do you want me to die, upstage or down?
Lem is too busy out there talking to that notorious Doll Davis.
Say, you know anything about Shakespeare?
Not a thing.
Well, neither do the rest of my cast, so we all start from scratch. Now, you sit right here, and I'll be right up in the middle.
Hey, what's she calling the Lord's name so much for?
Don't ask me. You know much about this here play as I do.
Folks, I know you'll be glad to hear that I've just engaged another professional, Miss Doll Davis.
He's a liquorhead.
Well, so was I. Sneezed until I got another chance. She's all right.
No too much.
Why, it's terrible bringing a cabaret girl in a church play.
You're right. She's a bad character and she'll ruin our show.
Oh, Lem Anderson must be losing his mind.
Nix, nix, nix. They come from.
Well, that'll be all for today, folks. No more rehearsal. Same time tomorrow.
Thanks.
Have some lovely weather, ain't
you? Mr. Lem, I don't think I'm going to be so popular around here.
Well, now, don't you worry about that, child.
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm going back to that liquor party where I just came from.
Oh, come on, doll. Snap out of it, honey. Don't you worry about anything anybody says. You're going to be in this show, and you're going to be good.
Mr. Lem, why are you so good to me?
Come on, kid. I'll walk you home.
Yeah.
There goes Lem with the doll now. You know what to do, Galloway.
Do something worthwhile for your mama. But what I wanted to say to you, doll, was that it's just a bit part. Do you think you like it?
Yeah, well, I'm kind of afraid of Ruff.
Ruff's
gone soft. We got to take this matter ourselves, huh?
Why, you're nuts yourself. You mind if I see you upstairs?
Well, I'd be glad if you would, please.
I'd be glad to.
Listen, I'll furnish you the getaway, though, you understand? If the trail gets in your way, blast her, too. Now get going.
Okay. Well, doll, honey, you just lay down and take a little rest, and I'm sure that you're going to feel all right in the morning.
I hope so, Mr. Lem. I feel a little better already.
Uh-huh. Goodbye.
Oh, won't you come in just for a little while?
Well, just for a few minutes.
Come on in, Mr. Lem, and make yourself at home.
Well, how do you feel now? Don't you think you ought to lie down for a minute?
No, I feel much better. Let me take your coat.
Oh, thanks.
Just sit right in that big easy chair over there. You'll what? Find all the theatrical papers right there.
Uh-huh, the variety.
You know, Mr. Lem, huh? I'll never be able to thank you for that part you gave me.
Oh, that's all right, doll. You just make good. That's all I want.
Won't you have a little drink?
Uh-uh, doll. That's done enough damage to me already.
Well, I'll have one.
Uh-uh. You better lay off, too.
I guess you're right.
Sure.
Oh, Mr. Lem.
Yeah?
Do you feel like rehearsing that part with me again?
Sure, I don't mind.
Well, I'll tell you what you do. Just sit there, just a minute. And here's my scrapbook. Here's all the pictures while I make myself comfortable. Oh. You'll find it very amusing.
Fine.
Say, doll, you've done some nice things according to this scrapbook.
Thank you, Mr. Lem.
Doll, I'm certainly going to help your career.
He won't.
Who is it?
Get it,
doll. Get on in the accident and
idea. Why don't you leave me alone?
You got it coming, chum.
I'm minding my own business. Haven't you done enough for me already? You killed my wife and you ran me out of town?
We told you to stay out. Now we ain't got no more patience. Say your prayers, actor.
Cut it out, Galloway. You know what Rock said. No shooting, no killing.
Be quiet, chick, or I'll kick your teeth down your throat.
Heck
with
what Ralph said.
Dog. Get away quick, Mr. Lem. They'll blame you. Gilson and Ralph. Watch out. Get a doctor.
Thank you, Miss Mamie. Thank you. Now, will you give me the potatoes, please?
Boy, you don't think gave me no potatoes up here.
Well, what is that?
You think, give me them potatoes. They don't even say the blessings up here like you do down home.
No?
No. They just say good bread, good meat. Thank the president, and go ahead and eat them.
You're such uneducated person. Such colossal stupidity. Why, boy, you is absolutely illiterate. You is absolutely illiterate.
You gonna run into my razor yet?
Now, stop that, now, stop that, now. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
You've enjoyed our show up till now. Fine. And what do you think? And now, ladies and gentlemen, for a wee portion of a Broadway atmosphere. And who do you think is going to give it to you? None other than an inimitable singer of songs, Laura New. All right. Here's you.
I gave you my love.
boss and I had a rough accident.
Tough time?
Yeah.
Over there.
I want to find out who shot Doug.
How do I know? I'm with you when it happened.
Where's Galloway?
Come, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe. Send you guys out to get something to act the guy without shooting, and you see what happens?
I got my alibi.
Hey, you. The guy named Anderson came here?
I don't know. He's drunk over there.
Oh, trouble. Come on.
Hey, you Ruff Jackson?
Yes, I'm Ruff Jackson.
Well, why don't you let me...
Hey, come on!
Although pronounced out of danger, Miss Davis is unable to supply the slightest clue to the police. And the producer, Lem Anderson, last seen with Miss Davis, is held for questioning.
Poor Lem. He never seems to get out of trouble. The chauffeur's tonight, and he's in jail.
Imagine my embarrassment. And if it hadn't been for such a tremendous sale of tickets, my people would wipe their hands of the whole affair.
The district attorney has agreed.
Under certain conditions. He will deliver Lem to the theater tonight on the police car.
You mean to say a policeman is going to be with him?
Exactly. And after the performance, Lem must return to headquarters.
You know we got to clear Lem of this whole mess.
No. You see, Lem is too stubborn to talk. And the girl, she won't talk. So there isn't anything further I can do.
But I can. I'll go to the hospital, and I'll have a talk with that girl.
Oh, Mr. Lem. Oh, my head hurts. Ralph, Galloway.
Okay for visiting?
Yes, Ben,
it's all right.
How did they shoot? Oh, Asha. Oh, my hair. Are you all right, Mr. Lem?
Yes, Mr. Lem is all right.
They didn't shoot him, did they?
No, he's alive. He ain't hurt none. He's only angry about you.
He's so fine and so good. And what they try to do to him.
If you really want to help Mr. Lem, you'll tell me what happened.
Who are you?
Just a friend of his, just like you.
They try to frame him, the mob. They try to run him out of town. They try to ruin him with the rich people, disgrace him. I took him to my apartment. He wasn't to blame. I just couldn't go through with it. He's always been so nice to me.
And then what happened?
I tried to stop Galloway from shooting. I tried to save Mr. Lem. Oh, do you think I'm going to die?
No, child. You're not going to die. The doctor says you're going to be all right. Who tried to run him out of town?
Ralph Jackson and Matt Gilson, that's why. Mr. Lem saw Gilson shoot Jewett. They were afraid.
Honey, child, you don't know what this means for Lem Anderson and for me.
Ain't no need to cry, little girl, because a lot of things happen in show business.
Yeah, you're going to cry about this. Our star's in jail, and he ain't going to get out. So you might as well take off your costume.
What? There's Uncle Lem now.
Where?
All right, Anderson. Go on with your show, but remember, I'll be here with you to take you back with you.
Wait. I'll go see you.
I understand.
Glad to see you, Uncle Lem. The folks are waiting. Could it go on?
Sure.
What are you waiting for? Get in the costume and the makeup and everything.
Hello, pal. Waiting for someone?
Yes, I'm from headquarters. I'm waiting for Anderson.
How'd you find us out?
Jack Adams. He told me. He was visiting Galloway before he left town.
So that's it, huh? Galloway shoots Dove, trying to get Anderson. There's only one guy in town could have given orders for that.
Sure. Matt Gilson.
Yeah. That's it. Matt Gilson, the lousy double-crossing rat.
Just in case.
Where are you going, boss?
I'm going where I know I'll find Gilson.
It is the cause, it is the cause, my soul. Yet, she must die or she'll betray more men. Peace.
It's wonderful.
Put out the light and then put out the light.
Yeah, go ahead and put out the light so we can all go to sleep.
I cannot give it vital growth. Must leaves with us.
Get away from there.
She waits.
Othello, won't you come to bed, my lord?
Nothing to himself, Amala. Here is my
Heaven has mercy on you.
Desdemona, with all my heart. Amen.
Some bloody passion takes thy very fame. I hope it do not point to me.
Desdemona, that handkerchief that I so loved and gave to thee, thou gavest Cassio.
No, no, my life, my love, my
sweet soul, take heed. Thou art on thy deathbed.
I'm my lord, but not to die, not yet to die. Yes, yes, yelling dance moon on.
To deny each article of oath, cannot remove or choke the strong connection that I draw with all. Thou art to die.
No, no, she shan't die. No, no, she shan't die. No, no.
Telling you, old rock church
Don't you hear all that applause, huh?
Well, there's your authority.
Well, then, get the clothes on. Everything's going to be all right.
And you were all fine in your part.
Each and every one of you.
You were the wonderful
lady. But Desdemona, I owe a lot to your way.
Still, it wasn't exactly the Othello that I
was. Well, it might not have been the Othello you fanned,
but you sure made him like me.
Put it out, honey.
Still looking for Lem Anderson, eh?
Yeah, and I'm gonna get you too.
Of all is this. I have an offer to go to Broadway with Othello, a jazz